So in today's short khutbah, we will talk about certain benefits, some of the many benefits that can be derived from one of the most comprehensive of the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ's hadith. And this hadith is known as the hadith of Irbab ibn Thariya. It is named after the companion who narrated it. And the companion's name was Irbab ibn Thariya. And it was so famous that this companion, when he is mentioned, the first thing that comes to mind is this one hadith that he narrated, because it was so comprehensive and so beautiful. This hadith has been reported by Abu Dawood and At-Tirmidhi and Ibn Majah in their Sunan, and also by Imam Ahmad in his Musnad, and it is an authentic or Hasan hadith. Irbab ibn Thariya starts off this hadith and he said, وَعَظَنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ مَوْعِظَةً, that verily the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam gave us a speech. So the Sahabi goes on and he says, وَعَظَنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ مَوْعِظَةً وَجِلَتْ مِنْهَا الْقُلُوبُ وَذَرَفَتْ مِنْهَا الْعُيُونَ. He now describes the effects that this speech had. And he said, our hearts trembled when we listened to it. And our eyes were crying when we heard it. Irbab continues in his hadith. And he said, فَقُلْنَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. When they heard this speech, and when they were affected so much, they said, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ كَأَنَّهَا مَوْعِظَةٌ مُوَدِّعٌ فَأُوصِنَا. It is as if you are about to leave us. It is as if you are about to give us a farewell speech. So then give us some advice. Give us your wasiyah. Give us your last will and testament. So the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ said, أُوصِيكُم بِتَقْوَى اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. I give you my advice, or the advice or the testament that I give you is for the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the Prophet ﷺ went on, and he said, فَإِنَّهُ مَنْ يَعِشْ مِنْكُمْ. Because whoever amongst you will be given a long life, whoever will live after this, فَإِنَّهُ مَنْ يَعِشْ مِنْكُمْ فَسَيَرَى اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. Whoever amongst you lives long. And this does not only apply to the Prophet's time, but after the Prophet's death. For example, us living in our time. That we are living at a time that is way after the Prophet's time. So the Prophet ﷺ described this time. He said he will see a lot of difference of opinion, ikhtilaf. A lot of ikhtilaf, you will find it. So in this statement, the Prophet ﷺ is giving an indication, or one of the problems of this time, of the time after him, that there will always be differences amongst the Muslims. There will be differences in their aqidah, in their belief. There will be differences in their fiqh, in how they worship Allah. There will be differences in their manhaj, or how they call to Allah. Everything there is different. Everything there is different. So the Prophet ﷺ warned us against this. Warned us against it, but how could he warn us against it without giving us the solution? And therefore he gave us the solution. He said, whoever amongst you will live, he will see a lot of ikhtilaf. فَعَلَيْكُمْ بِسُنَّتِي. So I command you, I put upon you, I make it obligatory upon you to follow my sunnah. This then is the success out of this fitna. And like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهِ. Whoever obeys the messenger, it is as if he has obeyed Allah. So disobedience to the messenger is equivalent to disobedience in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has himself made the status of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one to be obeyed. So the Prophet ﷺ then gave us the way out of this fitna. He gave us the way out of this ikhtilaf that we're going to have. He said, I command you to follow my sunnah. And then he went on and he said, وَسُنَّةِ الْخُلَفَاءِ الرَّاشِدِينَ الْمَهْدِيِّينَ مِنْ بَعْدِي. And the sunnah of the rightly guided khalifas, the rightly guided people that are going to come after me. And in this hadith, it refers to the companions. It refers to the companions, and in particular the major companions, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman and Ali. And then he said, تَمَسَّكُوا بِهَا. Hold on to it. Look at the emphasis he is giving. Had the Prophet ﷺ just stopped here, it would have been sufficient for us. But he is now giving us more and more emphasis to what he has just said. He said, تَمَسَّكُوا بِهَا. Hold on to it with your hands. And then he said, وَعَضُّوا عَلَيْهَا بِالنَّوَاجِذِ. And hold on to it with your molar teeth. This is an expression in the Arabic language, which means hold on to it for dear life. And then the Prophet ﷺ gave us the comprehensive advice that will keep us away from all evil. He said, وَإِيَّاكُمْ. And I cautious you, or beware of مُحْدَثَاتُ الْأُمُورِ, of newly invented matters, of matters which did not exist but were invented after me. Beware of them, إِيَّاكَ. It is an Arabic phrase that means caution, beware. And it is used to give a very serious danger that is going to come after it. So the Prophet is saying is beware of any newly invented matter. Because the Prophet said, فَإِنَّ كُلَّ مُحْتَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ. Every newly invented matter is going to qualify as a bid'ah, or as a religious innovation. And every bid'ah is a dhalala. And every bid'ah, every religious innovation will lead to dhalala, will lead to misguidance. And every misguidance is in the fire of hell. In this phrase, or these phrases, the Prophet ﷺ summarized for us the root of every single evil that will ever occur from the Prophet's time to the Day of Judgment. For verily, think about it. The only reason that we're having so much ikhtilaf today is because someone had to invent something else after the companion's time. Now people, they get a bit confused. They say, so should we be aware of electricity, of cars, of tractors, of technology? No, brothers and sisters, no. This is not what the Prophet ﷺ is referring to. Realize that when the Prophet ﷺ is warning us against innovations, he is talking about innovations in the religion of Islam, not in this world. It doesn't matter what we wear, what we work, how we go to our work, our electricity and ACs. This is not religion. This is not religion, per se. A bid'ah, or a religious innovation, is defined to be every act that has been added into Islam that was not a part of it, and by which, or through which, a person seeks rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the important key factor, that through this act, you will try to seek rewards. But this act did not exist in the Prophet's time. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in another hadith, he said, that man amila amalan, whoever does an act that our thing is not upon, that we did not do, it will be rejected of him. And in one hadith he said that on the day of judgment, I will see my ummah and they will all come to me. And yet some angels will come and push away a segment. So I will say, oh Allah, these are my ummah. And he will recognize them by the signs of wudu. Because the Prophet said that those who do wudu, there will be light shining from their hands and their faces. So the Prophet will recognize them. So these are not kafirs. These are not kafirs, they prayed. They did wudu and they used to pray, but the angels will come and take into the fire of hell. So the Prophet will say, Ya Allah, this is my ummah. And this hadith is in Bukhari and Muslim, by the way. He said, Ya Allah, this is my ummah, don't take into the fire of hell. So Allah will respond that you do not know what innovations they did to this religion. You do not know what they added to this religion. And at that, the Prophet ﷺ will say, Suhqan, suhqan, woe, woe, the fire of hell may be upon those who changed my religion after me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Al-yawma akmaltu lakum deenakum. This is one of the last verses to be revealed. Revealed only 4 months before the Prophet's death. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, today I have completed your religion for you, perfected it for you. And I ask you, something that is perfect, is it in need of being added to? Is it in need of being subtracted from? Something that is perfect in and of itself. If you added something to it, it would mean that it is not perfect. If you took something away from it, it would mean that it is not perfect. We have to be aware, we have to be cautious against those people that try to renovate and innovate Islam, thinking that Islam is going to change from time and place and culture. There is no such thing as an American Islam, and a British Islam, and a Pakistani Islam, and an Arab Islam. No, there is only the Islam of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فستذكرون ما أقول لكم وأفوض أمري إلى الله إن الله بصير بالعباد.